We're gonna get right into it. I had to unmute it because I'm muted. He's in a partner right now, so. Hey, Adrian.
Adrian.
He had aimbot.
Adrian.
Yeah.
You hear me?
Mm-hmm.
Alright.
You know what? This is what?
What is that noise? Apparently we're 82 overall right now, so. Because I just traded my good players for a quarterback.
And now we get a peek at some of the top players here.
I ain't be able to beat them. Oh my god.
Charles Davis ready to go in the booth. We hope you're ready to go with the controls. Let's play.
Ooh.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This will be fielded at the 6. Turn there, gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. And the offense ready for the first down and 10. Now a play fake here on first down. He's got the hook up to Odell Beckham. And he'll be out of bounds up past the 45. 14 yards there on the first play from scrimmage.
Had it, baby. There we go. There, baby.
Just run away. Oh, rocking, knocking.
Oh, man.
Turn up my music. Turn up my music, boy.
He just quit. Oh, my God. He clicks, I got a pick 6.
Dang.
I guess let's get to another one.
There's a galaxy skin. I just seen him.
That guy could have beat me anyway. He had like a 99 overall team, so. I don't know about it.
I don't know, man.
You never watch it, say your name down in the chat.
There's a dude on me, Luxon.
Here in the booth, this should be a fun one. Madden Ultimate Team matchup. As you get a look at some of the stars here on today's game, let's get right to it.
Dead. Last time I returned it with Barry Sanders. So.
Sebastian Janikowski ready to get us started. And we are underway from
of Indianapolis. Fielded about a yard deep.
Up here.
Take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line.
Balloons. Balloons.
So the Elks offense with it as they get ready to go. First and 10.
There's a dude. What? How? Gosh, Luxon.
Oh.
Can't believe it, Luxon. If I come to help you. You said there's people on you. End them. End them.
I don't even get the freaking fighter out of this one. I'm not even warmed up.
Dang. Cool.
Alright. He's in a safe of the three, so. Who is that?
Oh, gosh, Luxon. So trash.
What? Oh, he didn't get Buffy down.
So it's incomplete. He was trying to get it to Jermaine Kearse. And it's second down.
Out routes are always timing routes. And if the timing's off just a little bit, it can really throw off a play. Look like he let him go too much there.
Yeah, there was a fraction of a second.
Oh my God, take that.
And a hit, Jarnett Lewis. It's incomplete.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Now Gino, throw left side, complete to Schroeder. They get 14 yards there, and a first down.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one, and that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league. Those guys who can run, make plays after the catch, and gain that additional yardage.
And using that speed there to turn into a pretty nice little game. Over the middle, complete. It's Rice. And he's going to be taken down, but not before reaching the 15-yard line. A very solid gain of 27. From the red zone now, Smith. And that's off the mark, incomplete.
So many offense running through their running backs into their passing offense and be able to swing the ball out or check it down to them. But sometimes those guys are just not as comfortable catching the ball as they were running it.
Throwing is Smith. Dancing to his left. And he'll be taken down.
He hit him from behind.
Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They get him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he...
And he will take this one in for a touchdown.
Oh, my God.
Aaron Jenkins. A 2-yard touchdown grab. Have taken a first quarter lead. And he puts it through.
Inside.
Let's go, Snake.
Here's Janikowski.
That's a player.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
Bro, why did you not go blue house? This dude landed. No, I'm talking about this one dude. This one dude, he landed like right beside blue, right at the door, and he didn't even go there. Like what is you doing, man?
What Lulu right there? Can't do nothing, bro. The line.
So, Brandon, we sat in with a lot of coaches, and when they talk about things they want to accomplish offensively, I'm not sure that sack and sack are on their pro sheet. Garoppolo.
The dude's on top of me.
Dude,
are we on the same page here, Brandon?
Say yes, it's just these video games are tempting. You want to go downfield with it.
I like the way you've evolved. Yeah. You know, you've learned how to play it the Madden way.
Now the former Gamecock, Spencer Lanning, on to punt it away. Oh, it's a wobbler here. And not his best effort there, as this one's going to be spotted down just outside the 40-yard line.
Got it, baby.
Right here. Huh? Uh-oh. More people, I think, are coming. Yep. Come on, Lux. No, I hit him.
Oh, my God.
No.
All right, man, it's bad.
Now it's time to dance.
Baby, why are you coming up?
The intended target, the tight end, Austin Seferian Jenkins. And now it's second down.
Well, you got a receiver here. He's got one touchdown already in this first quarter. And they're trying to double his pressure there. Trying to continue to go to the guys. Already got into the end zone. But good coverage to make sure that this time it fell at the break.
I swear, bro.
That you see on the basketball court, you know, the guy with points, rebounds, assists, steals, one with the arm, one with the legs. Let's see if he can continue this pace.
And sending out the reminder that, yeah, look, I'm known for having an arm, but I can do it with the legs on occasion when I need to. And now the offense heading back out there, already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns early. Probably not very deep into their script. I think they're gonna stay with it. I'm gonna go abandon it.
I'm staying in the room because I can't pass.
Anything, at least 3 points, get that zero off the board.
Every year I go to the combine, I marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running now. Those that run like DBs. And let's face it, they try to finish plays too. Eyes up, head up, run right through.
And he'll take this one up close to the 25-yard line. Give him two on that run, and they're still left looking at a third and about nine to go. We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They've stacked him up pretty well, but when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you've got to play the long game. Keep handing it to him, and some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn into six, seven, eight, and maybe more later on.
Back alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon. It'll be Salt Lake football here as we get ready to start quarter number two, but likely not for long as they're in punt formation to kick it away. The offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on fourth and three. They do go for it. It's Garoppolo. They'll roll him out right. He may try and run for this. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
Now, hand off to
There we go. Hey, old Barry. I missed it. Why'd it go?
He's just gonna see the trap.
We're all over that.
Make her fumble.
Did you pull out your pickaxe?
On first down, Smith. Get that.
The tip there altered the
point,
and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down. Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field is popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch it.
Oh, you know why you get because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field.
In this case, no one came up with it. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. Calling a gain of three.
Most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, that can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Being chased out left, and he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Ray Lewis, able to get in there and drop him behind the line. A good play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Center back gets hit.
Oh my god, we're all over the head. Had a baby.
And this ball will be intercepted. Picked off by Champ Bailey. And he is going to get this one back to the 20-yard line. So a minute 55 to go in the first half. We'll come back to Indianapolis right after this. And again, this time to the tailback. And he'll take this one up to about the 23. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Now Garoppolo throwing on second. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
But one thing that I like defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. To the right side, it's Kelsey.
Hey, baby.
He'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. They get 9 yards there, and they get a first down.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Picked up a first down.
What?
Be
over there, up there. Check me.
They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains.
How you drop that?
Ball pops out, incomplete. So it can't hang on, and as I watch that unfold, I remember.
remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're going to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Well, you know a coach said that, right? Not an actual player, not a chance at all. Way easier said than done.
Sliding into the pocket. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. Gronkowski, the intended target, and that'll make it third down.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because they get completions on first and second down. They got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. If you don't pick up the first
down, that's where he's going to.
He's likely going to have to.
And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. They give him 15 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. They fake the give.
That was the ball.
It's a gain of 7, and it'll be 3rd and 10. And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going to want to be aware of him. Where is he lining up? What can he do? What kind of damage can he do to us downfield? And who can match up with him without weakening our overall defense? You're exactly right. It's a tough task to match up to him.
Give him 2 yards on that play, and it'll make it a second down. And now they come up and spike it to stop the clock. The offense on third down, they've hit it 50%, 3-6 to this point. This is 3rd and 8.
That's close. There you go.
Now the field shrinks. They struggle to convert, and that last incompletion brings up 4th. So they're still down, but they are able to salvage 3 here heading into the lockers.
This is what you work on from the beginning of training camp. Heading into the half, put some points on the board. No matter what the score says at that point, you've accomplished what you set out to do.
Now this offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And you got to think, if this is anything other than just taking a knee, I'd be very surprised.
Yeah, they've got enough to talk about at the half. Why do anything else? Just get out of there.
The final shot here before break. Smith, they'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he'll go down for a loss inside his own 5 at the 4. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the 3rd quarter. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. This one taken from the 7. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Out comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the 3rd quarter.
I like the way you term that because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. And like what they did in the first half, that worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies. Try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
See if they do just that. On 2nd and 10, Smith steps away to his left. Now he's going to let it go deep, and the defense moves him. It's complete, and he'll be out of bounds, able to take it down to the 40. A very nice pick up of 33 yards. Smith on 1st down. Buying time is left, and he overshot him there. It's out of bounds, incomplete. Well, they haven't had a whole lot of success in the passing game here. Now, in the second half, he's thinking, I guess maybe just take a shot deep.
I think you're right. Almost looking for a bailout, isn't he? Can my receiver
go? Fumble.
Can I create a penalty downfield? Maybe pick up an interference? trying to get going again, but you're right, he definitely took a shot.
They'll run it now, out of the gun. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right, he's pretty much been completely. And this will be a touchdown.
Absolutely.
Geno Smith from 17 yards out. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead. A good sustained drive there in this third quarter, capping it off with a touchdown to give him a nice two-score advantage.
That was actually a fun one to watch, wasn't it? I mean, for me, seeing the mix of what they did, how they moved the ball downfield, very sharp, too. Each and every play seemed to be executed with great dispatch.
Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half, other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run, these things worked well for us, and sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve.
Throwing the ball.
Incomplete. Kelsey, the intended receiver there, and it's third down.
Maybe a little frustration starting to creep in. The offensive line hasn't done a great job of protecting him in this game, and there he was, hit again as he threw it.
Yeah, another time on his backside. Probably starting to get a little frustrated.
Got to keep his composure.
Now he dropped that ball.
To the second half now. This is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off. This offense converted once on fourth down earlier. Now they're out there again to try once more. They'll try and throw for it here. He hits more, and he gets this one all the way up to the 40. 20 yards in the pickup there, and it's good enough for a first down.
Uh-oh. Maybe.
Time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage. I'm
no offensive mastermind, but of all the guys on the field to block, you might want to stop him.
Look, I've got a very simple rule. An unblocked defender is usually your best defender, and he ended up making the play there.
Escaping the pressure running, and down inside the 10 here before he's out of bounds, right around the 7. 6 yards there off the scramble, but it'll still leave him with a third down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a fourth down.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball in this drive, and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped up a very short game. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally, because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback. It makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
Sends it out to his running back. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. So, boy, that's already the third they burn here. They are out of timeouts now before we've even hit the fourth quarter. Now a play fake here on first down. Oh, he's got a little daylight. He's got room to run past the 20.
All right, I think I'm out.
Well, he's free going down.
Yeah, I can't come back this year. Oh, man, I can't come back.
Let me see the
remote.
No. I mean, do you
want to
lose this game?
Shut up. Well, I'm going to end it here.